We'd like to welcome you once again to this playoff edition of the Tiger Football Report. John McRoy joined by head coach of the Bentonville Tigers, Barry Lunny. Well, Coach, let's just go ahead and start. Last week we talked about you'd be playing in the state semifinal against the Conway Wampus Cats. Right. Talk to us a little bit about the preparation and what you emphasized in practice this week in playing Conway.
Well, a good football team, number one. When you get to this point in the season, like I told our kids and media during the week, you got a good football team on the other side getting ready to face the four teams that are left in playoffs. Obviously are quality football teams. Really have knocked off Harbor last week and very convincingly the way they did it offensively. And so that's where we started. They scored, gosh, what was it, 40 some odd points, I guess right. It was on Harbor, 300 some odd yards passing. So we looked at those things that they did really well last week against Harbor, somebody that we're familiar with and kind of know how they play, and spent a lot of time working on the passing game. They've got a very fine running game. They're big up front, lot like us, with their tackles, good size. They run the ball very well. Their quarterback gets in the pistol, but he's a little bit deeper than most, and then he takes three big steps, and he's somewhere around 10, 11, or 12 yards the time he throws the ball, and it's real hard to get to him. Pressure is very tough. So pass defense is going to have to be something we did really well, because he's going to be able to hold the ball for a while unless we just do an all-out blitz. So we spent a lot of time working on our coverage this week, and offensively, playing against them defensively, we felt we had some things that going into this week that we were going to work hard and take advantage of. We thought we'd see some things defensively that we did, and in fact we're able to take advantage of it. So we spent a lot of time defensively and offensively just really trying to hone up and shore up the things we do offensively and continue to get better at them.
Well, it was another exciting night at Tiger Stadium, and when we return from this commercial break, we'll go out to Tiger Stadium to look at the first half highlights. You're watching the Tiger Football Report.
When your car is in need of a facelift in Bentonville, the number one place for auto and glass repair is Bob Morey's Auto Body. From repairing a simple fender bender to a total reconstruction, our highly skilled team of trained professionals will spare no detail in restoring your vehicle just in time for that next tailgate. When their work is complete, you'll have a vehicle that's worth a little showing off. And while you're there, don't forget to stop by Tiger Tails, your one-stop shop for Bentonville apparel and accessories. We carry high-quality name-brand shirts, jackets, hats, flags, headbands, and pretty much everything else you can think of. So there's only one place to go when getting yourself and your vehicle ready for that next game at Tiger Stadium. Bob Morey's Auto Body and Tiger Tails, a very proud sponsor of your Bentonville Tigers.
Beaver Lake serves as the drinking water source for 1 in 7 Arkansans. Did you know that your actions can impact the quality of water in Beaver Lake? The Beaver Watershed Alliance is working to proactively protect, enhance, and sustain the water quality of Beaver Lake. With the help of partners, volunteers, and people like you, the Alliance is making a difference in Northwest Arkansas. Please learn more about your role in preserving the water quality of the Beaver Watershed and about how you can get actively involved. Visit BeaverWatershedAlliance.org. Beaver Watershed, our environment, our health, our home.
Okay, Coach, here we go. State semifinal.
They won the toss and wanted the football, and we gave it to them with the wind at our back, kicked it in the end zone. Come off zone play right off the bat. We actually had it kind of boxed up, and he did a really nice job of stuttering and finding the open hole. They run our version of what we call the pin and pull, and we overflowed a little bit too fast for it and weren't able. He made a real nice cut. Very good quarterback, nice quarterback. Threw and caught very well. Really, first half, I thought, if these guys keep catching like this, it's gonna be a tough night to beat them. I mean, they made some fabulous catches. It reminded me of LSU against Arkansas's catches in that ball game Friday afternoon earlier. We're getting a little bit more flow, and boy, Nick dropped in his zone just like he's supposed to. Big play. I mean, I can't tell you how big a play that was. They took the first drive and were moving it pretty good down the field, and keeping them out of the end zone or not even letting them have a chance to kick a field goal was certainly a big play.
Yeah, that was very similar to the interception he had a couple of weeks ago against Fayetteville.
Yeah, sure was towards the end of the game. We come back out and after interception and run our inside zone first play. Dylan had about, I think, 9 yards, maybe 11 there. I'm not sure. It was close to first down if he didn't get it. Came back and ran our pin and pull to the outside. Good blocking on the outside. Another nice run by Dylan. We came back in, a little play action pass. Really nice. We had a double post. Cody went first in front, and then they pulled the safety in, and Jimmy broke it off right behind, and we go down on our first score and make a nice throw and catch. Good start, especially with the wind.
And a chilly night, but really a good temperature, good night for football.
It was a lot better than last week with that freezing rain. Here's another look at it. Good play action, pulled the safeties up and the linebackers, and really nice throw and catch, maybe a tad behind him, but really a nice throw right off the bat. Gets us up 7-0. That was the start we were certainly wanting to have. Wish we'd have had them punt the football instead of an interception, but they got some good players. They're well coached. Clint Ashcraft does a great job with those guys. He's got that program really going. They run the pin and pull. We do a lot better job of it this time. For a loss, got to have that. Jared played one of his better games. I know coaches were really pleased with him. They think he really had one of his best games he's had in quite a while. We get him to punt. Almost get it from the backside. We didn't let it hit, which was the best thing we did right there. They cut our linemen. They started cutting our offensive line at a different time, which made it a little harder on the zone block. It's just a little bit different technique. And we didn't execute a couple of things there and force punt. Boy, I have to tell you, Bennett just nailed it into the wind. They filled it down on about their 4, 5, 6 yard line somewhere in that neighborhood. So we get him pinned backside. Darian Moore jumped over him. You don't see it there, but he jumped over the offensive lineman and made that play. And we knocked, it kills me looking at that. Our backside guy knocked our front side guy in, and we had him stop. We're going to have the ball at midfield, and we get a 15-yard rough the punter. That's just a no. Never do that. And give them life.
Especially when you got them pinned deep.
Oh, like gosh, we got the ball at midfield. I like our chances there. And gave him some new life. We got him on a fourth down a couple times. They tackled us actually on that play. I think I saw the penalty flag come out. One of the things we did, we lost our front side containment too many times with him. We got that corrected the second half.
Yeah, I think we'll see a play here in a little while where we actually contain when he tries to do that.
They came back and went for it on fourth down and made it, got in our wildcat, and we did not play that very well at all, and they scored a touchdown. You know, on that drive, we had a rough in the punter, which obviously gave them the ball back, and then we had a pass interference call. That later on gave them a first down after they'd had their penalty. So we had two costly errors and enabled them to stay in the ball game with us early. Good job on the edge with Jack. Our guys are blocking extremely well. Nice job, Dylan, finding the hole, staying to the outside. We had a third and four, and that's what we call our hide play, where it makes everybody think that we've handed it off on a power play. You saw Casey put the ball behind his back, just kind of stand there and had everybody. Safeties really came down hard because I saw the play action, and Casey standing there like that really did a great job. That was a nice call at a good time. You see it here. Now watch him just stand. You see Cody break loose and put the ball right on the line.
Kind of saw the safeties peeking in the backfield
peeking in the backfield. Shame on them, huh? We can't let them do that. And so we counter back there and go up 14-7 here in the second quarter. But it's again, you got a very good football team over there, and we know that they're not through. They're very well coached. They had a good plan. Good kick. We had coverage, was good. Nice job right there. They decided to go to the real quick stuff. Nice play. Way to break up on the ball. Austin did a nice job. Got some right over the middle, and there's a really nice play. Colton Ross, safety, came up and hit their tight end in the middle. You know, John, we talked about earlier, we were purposed not to let him get behind, and man, there's another one of those great catch. I mean, that was just a great catch. Ball's low, we had good coverage. Purpose not to let him get deep in the middle, and we decided we were gonna come back, and if they did catch anything, we were gonna come up and make the tackle, but don't let the ball be thrown overhead. And they scored, they scored right there before half, and that was a little disappointing, you know, that we let them go down the field and score. But again, that's a good football team over there. They're well coached. Their plan was, they were executing it. They were throwing a lot of the quick stuff on the outside. We weren't going to give them anything deep. And we just felt like that the matchups for us weren't quite as good to try to come up and play real tight on their corners. That's what Harbor had done and some of the other teams had done, and they were able to get behind them. And we decided, you know, let's make them beat us doing something that the hard way, not giving them the big plays and make them move the ball down the field and just see what happens.
All right, there you have it. Tigers and Wampus Cats tied up at 14 at halftime. We'll be back in just a moment for the second half highlights here on the Tiger Football Report.
Crane Hyundai of Bentonville is your hometown full-service dealer. Our sales department gives you access to hundreds of new and pre-owned vehicles, and our award-winning service department is here to fix your problem quickly and get you back on the road. At Crane Hyundai of Bentonville, everything we do is backed by the Crane Commitment, including a 100,000-mile warranty on every new and pre-owned vehicle and our 100-hour love-it-or-leave-it exchange policy. Come see General Manager Steve Hawkins and his staff at Crane Hyundai of Bentonville, located on Moberly Lane in Bentonville.
The drive to win is for life. And with Sprint, so is unlimited. Guaranteed. Switch now and save up to $100 off any phone.
Drink up. You're losing a lot of water out there.
Coach, if we're losing water, why don't we just drink water?
One day, it will hit you. Nothing hydrates quite like water. With no artificial colors, no calories, no sugar. Nestle Pure Life. Choose the crisp, clean taste of America's number one bottled water. Nestle Pure Life. Embrace the pure life.
Okay, Coach, 24 minutes of football to decide who goes to Little Rock.
Yeah, and we get the ball first, which is the good thing, and what we wanted to do. They kicked it off in the end zone, so we start at the 20. And this is a big, big series right here, just to come out. They did a nice job. First down, I think we only made like 3 yards on that. We got third and long. We'd had a holding penalty. Threw a beautiful screen pass.
What a great play call right there, too.
Really nice pass. Shouldn't have been in that situation. Jimmy got a penalty and didn't get rewarded for really being a very physical ball player and doing a good job. He really did a nice job. Got a Keeley in there, I think, right now. A little change up. Nice 9 yard, 8-9 yard run. They had a stunt on, and it was just the call. We would have been in great shape had they not had that stunt on, but they did. Linebacker came to the backside A gap, and the bootleg didn't take him out of it because he was already on that other backside. So that hurts us right off the bat. But we gained field position. Now they're on the 20. So even though we didn't go down score right then, we got them backed up. Here we go. Slow play on the front side, and now we got a chance. I'm not sure. Don't understand that. I mean, there's nobody over there. That should have been an intentional grounding, but. Stay outside, did a nice job, Javi did. And our backside guys got a chance to make a play when that happens. You know, a right-handed quarterback, you can't see everything. You can't look in front and back behind you at the same time. The front side guy is the one who's got to be slow playing. Boy, what a beautiful move. Great blocking. And great individual effort on Cody's part. He made the first couple guys miss. They really had him surrounded, and he just juked them out. And then he, once he did that, he got the outside. And you're going to get a better shot of it right here. We got two blocks, Tyrone and Tyler Nichols both at the same time. In, back out, there's one, there's two, boom, both of them on the ground at the same time. Makes a great cut, picking up some blocking downfield. Great momentum, and it really just got the emotion of the crowd, the team, and everybody. First play, we just run our outside zone, and we got everybody blocked up. Look at the blocking in the back.
That's amazing right there. Touchdown. That's teamwork right there.
You talk about changing the whole complexion of the third quarter. And that punt return, great blocks, and then the touchdown.
All right, 21-14, but a lot of football left.
A lot of ball left. But I love the feel on the sideline right now. It was really good. And the defensive guys were excited. They saw those blocks. A lot of those guys were on the punt return. They were anxious to get back out on the defensive football, on the football field, and do their thing. Good high kick gives us time to cover the field. Nice job. Real nice. Gone to pass. The middle was there. Made a nice throw and catch. That was one of the busted assignments. We didn't wall off with our outside linebackers. Got to do that. Keep your outside shoulder free. Nice job there. Turn the ball back inside. Javi did a great job.
Well, I thought the defensive line and going into the second half really started taking control.
They really did. Almost had an interception there. Forced them to punt. Huge. Well, they got a roll and starts us deep down inside our territory, but it's our ball. Fourth quarter. Come off the goal line. Good hole. Good hole. First down. Come back to power. Bounce it to the outside. Akili. Go, buddy. Go. And not a lot of people want to tackle him.
Well, this is big to flip the field right here.
Yes.
Oh, man.
That pains me. Just missed a touchdown. Just missed. Nice job, Dylan. Put that back spin. I wish I could hit a 9-iron like that on a sand wedge, but it backed it up. We give him a long, long ways to go, and that's, again, field position is so, so important. We didn't do the middle. We come up and make a nice lick right there. Ball's on the ground. I think Cody Scroggins comes up with it.
Yeah.
And as he alluded to in the paper, that was his guy to start with. He made a coverage mistake, and that was his guy he was supposed to have been on. And, you know, Cody, in his defense, he's not always over there all the time and doesn't get as much work on defense as we'd like for him to do. So he knew he made a mistake, but he was able to get back in. This was a big play, third and about eight. We run a what we call a hitch and hitch. It was a hitch and then sell it like it's going to be a go and then hitch back again. That corner really bailed out. And what you're not seeing here on that play, I think, I'm not sure if that was the measurement for the run that Akili made or that was the one that Jimmy did, and I think that was the one Akili did. We had a third and five play, and it was very, it was one of those calls. They're about out of timeouts, but we ran our power play, put a Keeley in, and I'm telling you, he fought, and made it about 6 inches,
yeah.
And that enabled us to run the clock out and secure the victory and get out of there with a 21-14. Really hard, hard-fought contest. Two good football teams, and it's what you expect in semifinals. Everybody that remains is a good football team, and so just tickled to death that this senior class has never, they've won all their playoff games here. They did not lose a conference game at home and only lost two games, which were non-conference this year at home in their whole career. So it's quite a record for these guys. We're real proud for them, especially this is our last game in this stadium. You know, we had senior night a few weeks ago, but this is our last game at this stadium regardless, and just very proud of this group that got to go out winning on the top end of this contest Friday night.
Well, the Tigers punched their ticket to Little Rock for next week's state championship game with a 21-14 victory over Conway. We'll be back in just a moment to preview next week's state title game right here on the Tiger Football Report.
Can I help you? Excuse me, hi. I wanted to find out about the Unlimited for Life guarantee.
Sure, Sprint is guaranteeing unlimited talk, text, and data for life.
Cool. And what if, say, technically you were not alive? Mm. Like, maybe you were undead?
Like a zombie.
Whoa, let's not go putting labels on people. I'm a zombie.
Unlimited from Sprint. It's guaranteed for life. Now for only $80 a month.
Crane Hyundai of Bentonville is your hometown full-service dealer. Our sales department gives you access to hundreds of new and pre-owned vehicles, and our award-winning service department is here to fix your problem quickly and get you back on the road. At Crane Hyundai of Bentonville, everything we do is backed by the Crane Commitment, including a 100,000-mile warranty on every new and pre-owned vehicle and our 100-hour love-it-or-leave-it exchange policy. Come see General Manager Steve Hawkins and his staff at Crane Hyundai of Bentonville, located on Moberly Lane in Bentonville.
So where does your water come from? Beaver Water District pumps and treats drinking water for the cities of Bentonville, Fayetteville, Rogers, and Springdale. Three other utilities also serve the region surrounding the lake. Visit Beaver Water District's website at bwdh20.org for information on what the lake and its watershed means to us all. Beaver Lake, you drink it every day.
All right, we're back here on the Tiger Football Report. Well, Coach, first of all, congratulations now as you're taking the Tigers to their fourth straight consecutive state title game next week in Little Rock. Different opponent this year, the Cabot Panthers, very good football team. I know you know Coach Mike Malham very well, and should be a great football game. Tell us what you know about Cabot.
Well, you know, I mean, you played against him. That tells you how old he is,
that's
huh?
That's right.
You know, Mike has been there for over 30 years at Cabot. That's his home. He loves it. They are always a really, really tough opponent. They run the old dead T, the inverted T, where the fullback is actually, it's kind of the inverted wishbone where the fullback in this offense is back behind the two halfbacks. And they dive the halfback, fullback comes off the edge, and belly, and then the option, and they got big linemen. They're foot to foot. They just come off. There's three. They make 3 and 3.5 yards. They're tickled to death because they'll go on fourth down. I don't know if it's anywhere around the 40-yard line, his 35 or 40-yard line, and he's got a yard or two. He's going to go for it. As evidence, we were listening to the overtime when they went to overtime the other night against North Little Rock after our game was on. Over with, and they were talking about him. Oh, they go for two. I said, I guarantee he's going to go for two. I know him. He's just that's ingrained in him. And very, very good football team. He told me on the phone a week ago. He said I'm good. He said we're good. And when he says that, you are. I mean, most coaches don't go around, you know, talking about that. He feels like they're a very good football team. He's not shy to talk about it. This group of seniors, most of them started when they were sophomores. He said, we took our lumps a couple years ago with them. As sophomores, there were like 8 or 9 of them that he was playing quite a bit. And they got a great rusher, and this Lonius, I believe is how he pronounces his name, fullback. He's one of the top rushers in the state this year. Defensively, they're just sound 50 defense, and hard nose, good linebackers. They got a safety that's one of the better players in the state. That's why they're there. That's why they're back in Little Rock after quite an absence, you know, by his own. I think the last time he was there was when we actually played Southside, when I was coaching Southside in 2000, I believe it was. And so, great program, and it's going to be different for us, and there's no doubt about it. You know, we go from what we normally see up here, and it's even different than what Rogers does. It's completely different. Rogers does a lot more option stuff and counter stuff, and this is just downhill, hard, smash mouth football. They're just going to challenge our manhood.
Well, let me ask you, Coach, now you guys will have a normal week of practice up here in Bentonville, then I believe you'll leave Thursday now to head down to Little Rock. And tell us a little bit about kind of what you'll do this week.
Well, we'll have, like I said, everything Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday will be normal. We're going to, hopefully we're going to be able to get out of here Thursday because more mid-morning sometime, because we'll get a time. Each school gets a allotted time at Wormhole Stadium to be able to go through a walkthrough. The kids get used to it, to go through a normal pregame practice. And so, you know, hopefully we're going to do a little bit of a brunch here with them before we leave and get down there around, you know, noonish and 1 o'clock and have a walkthrough and go to the hotel for the night and have a couple meetings and find a way to kill a long Friday, but beats getting on the bus and driving down there. So, I mean, we've done this before. I've been blessed to do this before, and so I kind of have an itinerary, some things we'll do, and to take up the time, but that's kind of what it'll look like this week as we go down.
Well, Coach, let me once again say congratulations to you, the staff, and these players for such an incredible season, and best of luck to you guys as you compete for a state title next
week. Yeah, thanks, John. I appreciate it.
Hey, and we want to thank you once again for joining us here each week on the Tiger Football Report, where we take you inside of Bentonville Tiger football. So long, everyone.
I told you, we get everybody's best. That's a really good, good football team. I don't know what's going on down in Little Rock area. I really don't care. I'm just going to tell you how proud I am of this bunch right here. I'm extremely proud of the fight that you have tonight. Again, Warriors, fantastic job. I'm just give yourself a hand, man. Let's go, coach. Hey. 3/4 of the mission is complete. 3/4 of the mission is complete. I hope you ain't satisfied. I hope none of us are satisfied. We'll have our work cut out again against another quality opponent, regardless whoever it is. Men, these are things the dream's made out of. See you in the morning at 8 o'clock. Nice job. Tigers, put it to reflection.
Ho, ho, ho.
Let's go.
Warriors on three. 1, 2, 3.
Warriors!
Yeah.